Rumor has it WWE no longer has interest in Crazzy Steve. Would you like to see him back in Impact Wrestling? This is BQ, and I do this for the Impact Wrestling fans.
Well, how about instead of focusing on those yahoos, you focus yourself on Eli Drake?
All right, discussion question time. But first, just give me a few seconds to tell you about a sponsor of the show that I'm really excited about. If you're familiar with daily fantasy sports like DraftKings and FanDuel, which I'm a big DraftKings and FanDuel player, I like playing for money. There's a company that I just got involved with called Draft. If you go to playdraft.com/BQ, what they're letting me do for you, when you make your first deposit, they will match that deposit so you get a bunch of free games to play. It's a lot of fun. It's much different than DraftKings and FanDuel because you can actually hold a live draft with 30 seconds between picks of the players. So say you're doing baseball, you pick two pitchers, three hitters in a little draft format. It's a lot of fun. So playdraft.com/BQ if you're a daily fantasy sports player. Anyway, Crazzy Steve, rumored by the fabulous Dave Meltzer.
Are you calling me a liar?
Is that after his WWE tryout that there is no longer interest in Crazzy Steve. For whatever reason. Now, all of us Impact Wrestling fans, I think we can agree that Crazzy Steve probably wouldn't have been set up for success if he were to enter the NXT ranks. That was just like my opinion, and I think it was the opinion of many other people. It's not that he's not a talented guy. He just never struck me as someone who they were that they were looking for over there, or that kind of style. That just, to me, that was an odd fit. I always felt like Impact Wrestling was a really good fit for him. Now, he was with the company for a while, you know, did some really good things with the menagerie, but he didn't really take off until Decay, at least not in my opinion. I thought he was kind of miscast in the X Division. I didn't really care for him in the X Division, but you know, I really feel like he turned that corner when he became Decay with Abyss, and obviously Rosemary played a really big role in that. I want to know, do you guys want to see him back? I mean, the company's been bringing people back and bringing new people, and sometimes it's like you kind of want to see people return, but at the same time, do you want to move away from them? I don't know what Crazzy Steve could do if he came back. Of course, the obvious answer to many people is, well, reform Decay or do a new, you know, version of Decay or teaming with Rosemary. Like, Rosemary is way bigger than Decay at this point, or anything they could do with that. Way, way bigger. It's like she doesn't need them. Like, they need her more than she needs them. Now, Decay was the hottest thing going last year. I mean, like what LAX is right now, that's kind of what Decay was. But, you know, after a really cool title reign, that whole feud with the Hardys really killed them, just like it killed the DCC. I mean, that's why in retrospect, letting the Hardys walk was a good thing, because tag teams were not bouncing back from losing to the Hardys. You know, the matches were so high profile, just for them to end up on the losing end, and they weren't really able to bounce back from that. You know, and Decay took a couple losses, the Reno Scum, and obviously that one against LAX at the very end. I mean, I guess they could, you know, factor him back into the storyline where they're getting revenge on LAX, and I'm sure Rosemary still wants her revenge, because, you know, I'm sure they were trying to build towards Rosemary and Diamante. That was impossible, but, you know, it's kind of getting off into a tangent. As far as Crazzy Steve coming back, I definitely wouldn't be opposed to it. I just don't know what they could do with him. You know, I don't think they could go back to the Decay gimmick, or maybe they can find, you know, a certain version of it for him as a solo wrestler, but to me, it's kind of an odd fit. I have to say though, I admire the guy for, you know, chasing a dream and going to a tryout and trying to get on, but it didn't work for him, unfortunately. And as I said, I just didn't feel he was a good fit over there. But he chased the dream, and I think Impact Wrestling is his home. But right now it's taking indie bookings. And I just really want to know in the comments, guys, you know, do you want to see Crazzy Steve back? Or is it time to say, okay, we're going to stop bringing wrestlers back? It's fun every once in a while, don't get me wrong. But are we going to say, okay, it's time to stop bringing wrestlers back, and we're going to focus on who's here and who didn't leave? And we're going to focus on some of these young talents that we want to bring in. You know, we want to focus on a Desmond Xavier. We want to focus on Garza Jr. We want to focus on, you know, knockouts like Diamante. You guys feel me? So I want to read in the comments what you guys think. Do you want to see Crazy Steve back? Please subscribe to the channel if this is your first time here. The next milestone is 2,000 followers. Trying to get to 2.5K by Bound for Glory. This channel slowed down a little bit because there hasn't been a lot of juicy news to talk about. But the last few days have been doing a little bit better. We are going to try to get to that 2.5K, but 2,000 is the next milestone. So please hit that subscribe button, leave a thumbs up, and can't wait to read the comments. Talk to you guys soon. Peace.